In today's rapidly advancing electric vehicle landscape, securing your charger installation is crucial. As EV adoption surges, these external installations are becoming increasingly appealing targets for theft and vandalism. In this video, we'll dive into the essential strategies for safeguarding your EV chargers against various threats, from the physical tampering or theft of charging cables to sophisticated cyber threats that could compromise your operations. Now, it may be impossible to stop a would-be crim from stealing a charging cable or any other part of the infrastructure, but we can deter them by taking sensible approaches. But how big really is the issue? In 2021 and 2022, a wave of thefts left EV owners on edge as criminals targeted their valuable charging cables. These cables, often costing over £200, vanished into the black market or were stripped for their copper. Thieves have targeted unattended vehicles, swiping charging cables whilst a car is on charge, and in some daring cases, they've even nabbed valuable cables straight from the vehicle's boot. So how can we ensure the safety and security of EV charging infrastructure in the ever-evolving EV landscape? This installation is in the centre of a medium-sized city which has sadly been victim to cable theft crime, so our client is keen to safeguard their equipment. The largest target for electric vehicles theft is the cable themselves. So is there anything we can do to keep the cables and even the chargers safe? Well, first, it's a good idea to understand why thieves want the cables. These cables, like the ones you carry around in your boot to plug your car in an untethered charger, have a value, with many appearing on well-known auction sites. Brand-specific cables can retail for hundreds of pounds, so a thief who sees a line of cars all on charge will see an opportunity to make a quick buck. So what can we do? It may seem like common sense, but you could stay near or inside your car while charging in a public area, rather than leaving your EV unattended. By monitoring both the vehicle and the cable, you can spot any potential thieves. But it may not always be practical. What if you need to carry out your morning ablutions? You could use a regular padlock for an easy solution. Just loop the cable through the car's wheel spokes and lock it with the padlock. Many EVs have a loop specifically for this, so you can lock the cable directly to the car. These methods, of course, won't prevent a miscreant from cutting the cable, but it is worth noting that if the charger is plugged in between the car and the charger, then it's likely to be pulling a current. This means that if the cable was to be cut, then the thief might get a nasty surprise. Many modern electric cars have a locking system built into the car, so once plugged in, the car will latch on and lock the charger in place. They can even send an alert to the car owner should the charger become disconnected. If you're charging your car at home, you can lock the cable into the untethered charger, even if the car is not on charge. What about chargers which are tethered, like these rapid DC chargers here? InstaVolt reported that it had 174 cables stolen from 27 of its sites over a 6-month period in 2024, with thieves targeting the cable to strip down the copper for its scrap value. This surge in thefts is likely influenced by the rising copper prices. However, the actual financial gain for thieves is minimal. Cables are not solid copper bars, but rather thin wires that require a lot of effort to extract the metal. 174 reported InstaVolt thefts have netted vandals less than £700 in total, given the effort involved in cutting and stealing these cables, and the fact that vandals often return to the same site, the payoff is quite limited. It's pretty much well known that a good way to deter a would-be thief is to ensure adequate lighting in the area you are trying to protect. Each job, of course, will be different, but on this one, we're going to be fitting these Tikwa fittings, which can be pole-mounted and mounted onto a wall, and we're going to be using these to light up the car park. To ensure the lighting is suitable and bright enough, I'm going to be taking advice from the SLL Lighting Handbook, which is 519 pages, which is anything but a handbook. So in this car park with 36 spaces, we have to ensure an even distribution of light for security and accessibility. Referencing table 20.2 in the SLL handbook, it is recommended that we aim for 10 lux for a medium-sized car park like our one. Fitting the lighting to poles will avoid glare to drivers and will help in the dispersal of light. So for our car park, we will be installing 3 lighting poles using the Tigua XL pole mounting solution and then using the Tigua X wall mounted options. And all of the lighting will be fed from the feeder pillar as well. Well, lots of companies are investing in CCTV systems to cover the sites. This is a great solution, but would require specialist input from a CCTV professional, something which we will cover in a later video. But what we can establish is that where CCTV is going to be used, we need to ensure the lighting is suitable, not only for the area, but for the CCTV, and that it can pick up images clearly for potential future identification. Now let's talk about the role of RFID technology in enhancing the security of EV chargers. RFID, or radio frequency identification, uses electromagnetic fields to automatically identify and track tags attached to objects. These tags can be embedded into access cards or vehicle identifiers, acting as your personal key to initiate a charge. In a commercial setting, RFID ensures that only authorized personnel have access to charging equipment, preventing misuse or theft. Businesses can effectively monitor and control who is using the chargers, track usage patterns, and ensure that only registered vehicles are being charged. A strong back office system can detect if chargers go offline or if any irregular activity is detected, such as an attempt to use the charging station outside of authorized hours. An alert can be sent to the duty holder to notify of the unauthorized access. These Sienna chargers have teamed up with the Monta app, which in my opinion is a good move. Monta has been on the EV market for some time and is industry leading in monitoring EV charger users for business. So in this car park, there will be a mix of business use as well as public use. Through the Monta app, we can assign RFID cards for the business side and set up different pricing plans to the public use charging. Through the back office, we can also monitor the usage and set up when the chargers are available to different individuals and even allow EV car owners to queue for charge using the Monta app. Access control systems can also bolster the security of EV chargers within a commercial car park, and the barrier technology can be powered from the feeder pillar, but these can increase the cost of the installation. So is there any other way to ensure that our charger points remain safe? Well, another smart solution is using a liquid which has a unique fingerprint which can link the cable to the owner and site. The liquid has a unique forensic signature that's invisible to the naked eye. You can apply it to cables, chargers, or any asset you want to protect. If someone with bad intentions touches it, they'll be marked with a substance detectable under a black light. And this method of protection has a 100% conviction rate, which is pretty impressive. Finally, this final piece of advice is for anyone who may be using a car charging point with a payment terminal. Criminals have been increasingly targeting EV charging stations with card cloners, which scan your card and record its details, including your PIN if you enter it. Be sure to check the payment terminal for signs of tampering or damage before you use it. Or, if you are unsure, use an application directly like the Monta app, which supports Lewden's Sienna chargers. Thank you to Lewden Palazzoli for supporting this series of training videos. And be sure to check out the rest of the videos that I have done on commercial EV charging over on our know-how page at efix.co.uk. But from me, it's bye-bye for now.